Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students of class 4. How are you all? Hope you will be fine and enjoying good health in these days. In the previous lecture, we have discussed word problems. In this video, we will learn money as expenditure and saving. Today, our topic is money as expenditure and saving. The money can either be spent or saved. Money spent for buying is called expenditure, and money left after expenditure is called saving. I repeat, money spent for buying is called expenditure, and money left after expenditure is called saving. Let's take some example. If we have 50 rupees and you buy a pen of rupees 30, rupees 30 is your expenditure. And the money left after expenditure is saving. It means 20 rupees are left and that is your saving. Saad gets rupees 200 as his pocket money each week. If he spends rupees 175 in the first week, he will save rupees 25. If he spends rupees 25 in the second week, he will have zero savings because he has spent all the amount that he has. In the third week, if he wishes to spend rupees 300, can he do that? Yes or no? No, he cannot do that. Why? As expenditure must be less than or equal to the amount of money a person has. His saving is rupees 200 and his expenditures are 200. He has zero saving now. So he cannot spend rupees 300 more. From total earning, if we subtract expenditures, we get saving. If we add expenditures and saving, we get total earning. From total earning, if we subtract saving, we get expenditures. Mr. Khan earns rupees 25,000 per month. His expenditures are rupees 24,000. What is his saving? To find out his savings per month, we will subtract his expenditures from his total earning. His total earning is rupees 25,000 and his expenditures are rupees 24,000. From 25,000, if we subtract 24,000, here we are left with 1,000 rupees. It means 1,000 rupees is his saving. If the total earning is rupees 32,500 and expenditures are 30,500 rupees, what will be the saving? Yes, students, can you tell me? If the total earning is 32,500 rupees and the expenditures are 30,500 rupees, what will be saving? We will subtract the expenditures from total earning. And the total earning is rupees 32,500 and his expenditures are 30,500 rupees. If we subtract 30,500 rupees out of 32,500 rupees, we get 2,000 rupees. It means the saving is 2,000 rupees. If the expenditures are rupees 40,000 and saving is rupees 20,000, what will be the total income? Students, think about it. How we will find out the total income if expenditures are rupees 40,000 and saving is rupees 20,000? As we know that total income is the sum of expenditures and saving. Expenditures are 40,000 rupees and the saving is 20,000 rupees. If we add expenditures and saving, we get total income. If we add 40,000 and 20,000 rupees, we get 60,000 rupees. 60,000 rupees is the total income. If expenditures are 40,000 rupees and the saving is 20,000 rupees. If the total income is 100,000 or 1 lakh and the savings are rupees 20,000, what are the expenditures? As the saving is the amount that is left after expenditures from the total income. From total income, we will subtract saving and we will get expenditures. From 100,000 or 1 lakh, if we subtract 20,000, that is saving. From total income, we are subtracting the saving. And we will get rupees 80,000, that are expenditures. In this video, we have discussed money, expenditure and saving. In the next video, we will learn about profit and loss. Take care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.